Hello and welcome back to episode 11 of City Skylines Let's Play Figaro. Today we're starting in the suburbs of Autumn Park in Figaro. I feel like this is one area of the city that we've kind of not paid too much attention to, but it is pretty much the heart of the city. This is the old city as it is, and I've preferred to start in the downtown cores to look at the new buildings and the sunrise and sunsets and stuff like that. But this area is actually quite beautiful to look at, and it has a nice view of the city from here. There's a gazebo here. Let me find a good spot. I found one earlier, but I seem to have lost my place. We can go up, I guess, one street. Let's see if we can find that perfect area. I think this might have been it. Yeah, from here, I can see the statue of the worker that was in our splash screen on YouTube. You can see that new monument building there, and I'll explain later why there's these new buildings. And there you can see the smokestacks of the industrial area on this side of the river. Those are more commercial that we zoned. And that is the commercial strip. You can see the hotels, and you can see the windmills in the background there. And then if you look over here, you'll see the tall towers of Cypress Park over here, and then closer behind us are the high density areas of Autumn Park. It's only about a block or two. And then over there are the tall buildings of Kings Park and the University District, as well as a new commercial area I was zoning up. So, between episodes 10 and this episode, I've played about two and a half hour of the game without recording it, and there was various reasons for that. I just wanted to get a few things done, and you know, maybe getting a 15 minute quickie playthrough ended up being an hour, stuff like that. So I also felt like I want to progress a little and then show what happens after that, rather than doing hour by hour playthroughs, because we're getting to the point now where maybe I could be spending 1 hour fixing traffic, and I don't know if that's interesting to some people. And I might do episodes like that in the future again, where I do back-to-back episodes. But in the meantime, I think the next few episodes, at least, I will be playing one or two episodes back-to-back, and then playing a couple of more hours without showing it, and then jumping back to show you what's changed. And in this case, a lot has, because what I've been doing is basically, in the last 2.5 hours, I was able to buy this new plot of land because I hit 36,000 people, and I built my my harbor here, and it's actually been doing pretty well. I'm getting a lot of tourists. You look at all those people waiting there, coming in, and I can click here. There's 25 people on this boat, and the amount of people on a boat ranges from 25 to 84, almost a full boat. And I can check here in my city statistics, my tourist income and tourists are way up. I'm not sure what happened here to cause this spike, but it's been downhill since then, or at least stable. So this here looks like a big change for us, and I can tell because I can visually see the tourists arriving. Before you have a harbor, your tourists arrive through the highway systems that you have here, but now we can see them arrive through here. And my only guess for this big drop is maybe I changed something with the traffic and didn't realize that I cut off a major tourist road, maybe a highway that they were using to get to the city. I cut them off, so now I've just kind of dropped all the way back down. I'm just recovering to my previous highs. Or this might have been a blip. Something happened in the city that I didn't realize that caused tourists to come. But yeah, so but right now it looks like we are maintaining that momentum, so I want to keep that going in the meantime. And I'm pretty, I want to make sure not to zone this area right away. Like, my first instinct is to want to zone commercial right away so they can drop by and visit. Rather, I want to bus them through, and I have a bus route going through here. I want to bus them in to my, where does this bus? The bus, I do have this new tourist trap here, so the buses stop here to drop them off, but they could, a lot of them also come here. And then they go directly to the metro station. You can see that happening if I go here. And every purple building are the buildings that the tourists visit, and every purple person are tourists that are in the city. So they're not living in a city, they're actually from another city. I can click on one of them, you can see here. Let's zoom down further. And this guy is a tourist, and he's going to a pub. So, as the buses come by, you'll see them drop off more and more tourists. You can also see them, a lot of them are going through the metro station. And there, these purple cars are tourists' cars. I guess rentals. And let's follow one of these buses back to town. Which one has more people in it? That one also only has one, that one has zero. And let's see here, this one coming here has 55. And do we have a bus here? Yeah, we have people waiting. We can wait for a bus to come pick them up, like now. And then just follow this bus and see where the tourists go. And they also go through this road to go home. So it's good. My buses get to pick them up and drop them home. Both ways. So a bunch of them got off. Pause. Let's pause that game real here. So a bunch of them did get off here. But let's continue. Where's the bus? There we go. There's a tourist on the sidewalk there. And also, the other thing I think I forgot to mention is between episodes 10 and this episode, I took the time basically to film the city as it was. So basically the city you saw at the end of episode 10, and did a bunch of videos, so like time-lapse looking videos, and I spliced it all together into like a tribute video for... Okay, yeah, you can see them going to the metro station. I spliced them all together into a tribute video for the first anniversary of City Skylines. And I've always wanted to do that. I actually had a piece of music in mind for years and years. And I wanted to do it initially for SimCity 4. That didn't pan out. And then SimCity 2013. That didn't work, obviously, because I changed my mind about that. So City Skylines get a tribute video, and so I spent 2-3 days just filming the city. So I'll put a link in the description below, as well as to annotate the video. Hopefully I remember to do that. And yeah, so it was just the city as you saw in episode 10, in its full glory. I thought the video turned out really nicely. I'm pretty happy about the result. So that's also the other thing I did in between the two episodes. And then I played 2.5 hours after that, just to kind of as a victory lap, because I was so happy the way the video turned out. And, you know, it's... And, you know, the reason why I felt like, you know, the video, or at least the this game needed some kind of a celebration for what it is, because in such a difficult marketplace, if you think about all the studios closing, and EA basically killing off Maxis after the failure of SimCity 2013, although failure in quotation marks, because the game still sold millions and millions of copies, but their costs were so high, and they got completely embarrassed out in the market because of the fan revolt from their stupid policies, DRM policies, that caused a lot of people to not buy the game. So basically after that, you know, they said, oh, we'll play nice, we'll give you a free game, etc., etc. But then they just turned around and fired Maxis, or dissolved Maxis. So after that, you think about, like, can we get another city builder? And, you know, we got one. And the city builder that we got is City Skylines. So I felt like, yeah, it deserves its own celebration for being able to exist in such a difficult market and delivering what SimCity 4 couldn't. I mean, compared to SimCity 2013, compared to SimCity 2013, this game has lower production values, but it still managed to look great. This game doesn't have the resources as EA did, but they managed to create a simulation that's better than SimCity 2013. And one of the things with SimCity 2013 was basically the Sims followed the road like electricity or water in that game followed the road, or even sewage. So yes, they did simulate the Sims, but the Sims didn't really have a permanent place of work. They just basically woke up each morning and flowed through the road like sewage until they found a place that needed an employee. So it's like a complete communist utopia if you think about it, because, you know, your proletariat can be a doctor one day, and the next day he'll be a farmer, and the next day after that a retail worker. So it angered a lot of people. I think the thing with SimCity 4 was, not 2013, but SimCity 4 was, at the time, it gave people a view of the future, because that was the first game that actually had this thing called automatons. And basically, it's basically when you zoom in close enough to the city, you can actually see cars that are not like plastered animations, but actual real cars that had a place to go driving around the city. And you even had people walking through the streets. And in the morning, you'll see school kids run to the schools. And in the evening, you can see them going back home. It basically gave people an idea of what the future could be. So, but back in 2004, when SimCity 4 was new, that technology was mostly aesthetic. So the game will simulate the city, and then it'll tell the automaton engine that this road here is well used by cars and pedestrians. So the game will know to put in a lot of cars and a lot of pedestrians. But the innovation that they did in SimCity 4 was the cars and the pedestrians aren't just animated GIFs that are just walking down the road, but they actually had their own little AI running in the background. So they will react to things like street lights. So if a pedestrian hits a red light, they'll stop and wait for the cars to go through. Same with the cars. And then if there's a crash, the pedestrians might run away, or the cars will spin out of control. And so stuff like that. So basically, the automatons were there to simulate traffic, but they also reacted to the environment. They didn't just walk in a straight line. So they would stop for other cars, they would stop for street lights, or not street lights, but traffic lights. And they would run away if there's a fire, right? But if you follow them long enough, those things will depop, because they might walk through a part of the city that is no longer as busy, and the game will say, okay, depop, because this part of the city has no pedestrians anymore. So they'll just fade away. So, yeah. You do see the curtain unveil itself in that scenario where the trickery is revealed. But, you know, in that moment when you first zoom into the downtown core and you see a lot of people, you see people stopping by the stop signs, you see people entering and exiting the metro stations, the subway stations, it felt real. Like, it felt like you're watching your city for the first time. So what, at least for me personally, I wanted to see was to take it to the next level, which was to actually simulate all those people and have them live in that city. So SimCity 2013 was supposed to be the game to deliver that. And it did approach the problem in a very similar way as City Skylines. It basically did approach it and say, yes, we are going to simulate each individual person in that game. But unfortunately, they made a lot of compromises. So I talked about the population flowing through these roads to their nearest jobs. And the same thing happened when they go home. They don't go to the same place. They go home to the nearest empty building. And the other compromise they made was the population numbers. So you'll see something ridiculous like 50,000 people, but your city would be like maybe something like this big, right? You'll have your residential, maybe a little bit of industrial, and then your downtown, and the game will be telling you 50,000. You're saying, no way is there 50,000, and there isn't 50,000 simulations in your city. It's just a number that the game made up, an approximation, right? Maybe one little guy you see down there equals five people or something, and the number constantly changes, so it's not like a linear simulation. So as your city grows, the numbers will actually not grow as quickly as your actual number of simulations, but it gives you a false impression of size early in the game, because you look at a 10,000 size city, but probably there might only be 100 people actually living in that city. So there was a lot of people upset about that. I mean, there's the whole online thing as well, always online, although they eventually backed down, but the game never really recovered from that. All the lies, I guess you would say, are the false promises, the disappointing disappointments that people had about it kind of put people off. So, I mean, this is a long-winded discussion, but, you know, this is why I think as the first anniversary of the game was coming up, I felt like, yeah, I like this game a lot. This is kind of the city builder I always wanted to play. like, right down to being able to click on people and track them. Like, I can just hit this, and we know where they live, we know where they're going, and you know, well, right now they're not working, so this person's unemployed. And he's not going to change where he lives tomorrow, right? And he's still going to be unemployed tomorrow, because other people have the jobs and not her. So it's that kind of thing that is what I've always wanted to play, and yeah, it deserves its tribute. And you know, it's nice to be able to play a game like this in such a difficult market. You don't see very many of them anymore. I mean, in a way, it's a bit of a golden age for indies, but a game of this scale, very difficult to produce, and I'm really glad that we got it. Okay, so still debating what I want to do with this. I've got an interchange here. If I build the port, Oh, I didn't know they added tunnels. Well, that's something new. I learn something new every day. So, let's see if this works. Still saying that there's no road connection, so maybe I should demolish that. Create a road. Just mirror that and have something like that come in here. No road connection for some reason. Is there something up here? Just testing a bunch of things here. Nothing. I haven't really decided what I want to do here. What if I do this? Will that work? Watch this here. Not really quite sure what I need to do here. I'm just testing out different routes. See if there's get a solution. This looks like it's connected. Because there are cars getting here, so I don't know what it's saying by not being connected. Thank you.
That doesn't really fix it either. I need to figure something out here. No road access. I don't know what else to do here. Let's try this again. I'm just gonna hook up this small road first. Too few services. Yeah, I only see tourist boats coming through, so there is something I'm not doing right here. It's causing... Oh, I finally see a freighter coming. So, yeah, so I'm gonna leave this going for now. This here has a lot of traffic, so I want to increase its capacity here. But I think the problem is just there's too many intersections here. I might have to think about fixing that eventually, too. So I can relocate a lot of my industrial to this area here, if I need to. I'm thinking it might make more sense, especially if this here, if I free up a lot of industrial here. For commercial or something like that. Where did that police car come from? This road is not even connected. Oh, he must have gone all the way down here and then did a loop. Yeah, they're gonna make their turn here. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna fix this because that's costing us a lot of time. Or the trucks a lot of time. I'm just gonna do this for. Oh, I hate this. It's another intersection. Another intersection. That's not my intention. Yeah, this here is a little bit bad with the traffic jam, so I have to think about that. Power here again. Oh, my oil power plant is on fire. That's not good. Gotta build a backup. I might have to redraw some of these. Roads later. Not too happy about them. They're kind of hodgepodge. And it looks like we're exporting about the same thing, so I don't know if we are simply... I'm going to turn this off now. If we are simply... shifting goods being transported from freight to cargo ship. Pause there, let's see. Yeah, this is going up 40% full. And I think the traffic here has gone down significantly. Entry. So we're having issues filling jobs at the moment, and I know my city can hold more than 37,000, so I'm missing something here. Because we're low on leisure. We are getting these buildings upgrade, but, you know, I still don't understand why we're kind of tapping out at 37,000, 38,000, when we've shown that we could hold a lot more people before. At least a couple of thousand more. Oops. I just dropped the mouse there. So our cargo ships are leaving 32% full. Yeah. Oh, well, that explains some of it. This should go out like this. How's our unemployment? 3%. So the game is telling us we are at full employment, we need more people, but we have buildings sitting here that's not completely full. It can house 6 more households. It's not filling up, so we do know that there's a lot of people dying off, but right now because of the seniors, but still, there should be more. I wonder if it's just a matter of running the simulation long enough to cycle through this generation of people, but we'll see. Just gonna zone some more residential and see if that helps a bit. Thank you. Just adding a new bus line here. So, see if I can get bus line 22. Change this color. Cypress Metro Line is what I want. That's not good. I'm going to... No, I don't want bus line number 22 there. There's too many buses. Delete line. Should there be something that's not working here either? Traffic jam here. I'm gonna watch this area here again. I don't know if adding that new bus line screwed it up, but it seems like there's something that's not working here. If I were to do a bus line, I probably don't want to stop here because this area here is too crowded, and the long buses just make it more difficult. So let me try something different here. I want a simple line with like this, and then we'll do a stop. So this is going this way, We'll do a stop here. And then we'll do a stop here. See if that works. And that should be bus line 22. Make that purple. Looks like we're fine here again. That was just a one-time thing where the buses got congested earlier. But we'll see once the morning hits if it's still an issue. But this here, this bus area here is really well used. This bus is full. Okay, we have another bus coming here. 100 passengers. Okay, we cleared it out. Looks like we're fine now. So had this other bus here drop people off just slightly away from the metro station, they can walk there, but this is kind of just servicing this one here. Actually, I can probably add stop here as well. Getting traffic jammer here again. Yeah, this is a problem. The buses are depopping. Fix this by moving the stops. Yeah, so I think having three lines there just creates a bit of a havoc, so I have to watch. Maybe I can delete this line here, or move it. The Elk Hills line, I don't need it to be select none. Check here. Because it's competing, no, maybe it's Cypress Park line? Yeah. So this one's competing with space with the blue line, which actually is actually taking a lot of people, so if I can divert this to a side street, do that. There we go. This is the one that really is carrying the most people. So we want it to not get bogged down. It's the morning again. Let's watch, see how that goes. I turned down the funding a bit because I was worried that maybe there's too many buses just going here. I know we want more buses, but that might cause more problems than what we intend, so I'm going to see how this goes. Well, not good. So there's just traffic, a lot of traffic here. I feel like I have to do this. Might have to rezone that. Yeah, didn't want to do that, but didn't really have a lot of choice. Let's try this. when you have a bus full of people just disappearing, that's 140 trips that are going away. So it's very important that we have the buses getting to where they need to go. And I really hate having to rezone the residential area that I've kind of spent so much time trying to save, but yeah. So I'll pay attention to this again after I've finished playing this game, but I'm wondering if the heavy traffic ban is might be causing this as well, so I'm going to turn that off. Because I don't know exactly what's causing so much traffic, and it's not the buses that's really essentially causing it, it's just during the morning. Oh, there's no heavy traffic ban here. During the morning, there's just a pile up here that causes the buses trying to turn up here to get stuck. seems to be working better today. Okay, I think we're running slightly over time. Again, traffic problems dominated the latter half of our game here. Wasn't my intention, but I didn't realize what was happening here until I started paying attention. So I'm going to be paying attention here as well. This area also looks to be a bit of a problem now, because I think what the AI is doing is trying to path through here, to cut through here to get to the freight, and that's exactly as I feared. Is it's trying to get to the freight station. So I'm thinking maybe I should actually do a rail line here and drop off my my goods at basically close to here, and just not have this direct connection between the the freight and the cargo terminal. But that's going to be a long-term project. I have to think about how I want to structure it, because I can't somehow avoid not having a connection here between Arma Industrial and the rest of my city. So I have to somehow make it so that it's easier for them to travel through here. And maybe one thing I could do is do heavy traffic ban along here, so they would prefer this route rather than going through the city. But that's an experiment I'll have to do, because it might cause problems later on as well. Okay, I think we'll end it here. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you next time.